thing was pretty good. Welcome back here, buddy. It's Frocket Tuesday here on the Cut Report. In last night's Republican debate, it was very clear that Mitt Romney and Michelle Bachmann, by design, pounded away at Rick Perry. Whether it was going after his Texas jobs record, the decision to mandate HPV vaccines to young girls, Social Security Ponzi schemes, or letting children of illegal immigrants pay low in-state tuition at Texas colleges. That's a position I favor. Anyway, they went after him hard. So our question is simply this. Did they succeed? And is Perry electable? Let's bring in our panel. Sam Cedar, political commentator and host of The Majority Report. Jimmy Pethakoukas, Reuters Breaking Views columnist and CNBC contributor. And Mark Simone, WABC radio talk show host. I go to you, Mark Simone. First up, the question. How did Perry survive the debate last night? He came in as the front runner. Will he continue that status?
Oh, absolutely. This was a great night for him, even though he probably got beaten. He got beaten like maybe 9-7, which is pretty good. Romney's been doing this for 8 years. Perry's been doing this for about 8 minutes. So he took a lot of body blows from every side. He will be so toughened up, so tuned up by debate after debate after debate that a year from now, when he goes against 98-pound weakling Barack Obama, who hasn't been in a debate in years, he's going to clobber him.
He debates with a teleprompter. Obama, right? He puts he goes against the teleprompter.
Even he seems to be battling that teleprompter.
Yes, he does. Okay, Sam Cedar, you heard Mark Simone. Are you ready to change your voter registration, Sam?
Not quite. I got to say that I thought, frankly, that President Obama was one of the winners from last night. I think when Ron Paul refused to answer that question as to whether or not he would let that 30-year-old die because he didn't have health insurance. In fact, he did essentially say he would let him die, and certainly the audience cheered on the idea that he would die. I think that actually helped President Obama, because President Obama is going to run against the notion that these people don't care.
There's like one guy.
He's not going to run.
There's like one guy.
You know what? I might concede that if President Obama ran against Ron Paul, it would be a close race.
But the real question is, how would Rick Perry answer that question? And that's what Ron was doing.
That's such a red herring. Come on.
Sam Cedar wants to debate. All right, go ahead. I want him to debate.
Please. Now, listen, you're focusing on what one person yelled out to act like that is somehow the platform of the Republican Party is to let 30-year-olds die on the streets.
Ron Paul was saying, in fact, yes, let him die.
No, that's not what Ron Paul was saying.
That die in the church, not on the street.
Well, I mean,
listen. Don't you believe in charities? Don't you believe in religious charities, Sam?
I don't think that's necessarily a
policy. That's what Ron Paul was saying.
And the real question
is, why are we talking about
how
Ron
does Rick Perry
is
answer
Ron
that?
Paul
because
front
the
runner?
Only
how does,
thing
how does,
in
how does
the,
Rick Perry answer that question when they ask him that question?
Yeah, listen,
the next
listen.
If the only thing helping President Obama
he
is
said
that
he did not like that. He said he did not like that like one guy who shouted out. He said he was taken aback by that. So there's your answer.
All right, let me go to something a little meatier. How much sting did Michelle Bachmann get? I'll go to you, Mark Simone, on this Gardasil, the HPV vaccination and so forth. And the charge, not only the vaccination, which, by the way, a lot of doctors are out today saying it's an excellent vaccination and it does save lives against cervical cancer, but the crony capitalist charge, the charge that Merck put him up to it, that his chief of staff, Toomey, was the go-between. Now, is this something that's going to dog Rick Perry?
It doesn't sound great, but I don't care what candidate you get, Barack Obama, Mitt Romney, they're all going to have some baggage with him. This will be a piece of baggage. Everybody's going to have some problem like this. If it was 30,000, I think that's the highest figure we've heard out of a $30 million campaign, that's not a big donor, and maybe the chief of staff was lobbying for them and helped push it.
But
it's not a big deal.
Thing. There's also that venture capital fund going to contribute.
State-run Texas venture capital,
right,
where they parcel it out to some.
He's
people.
Done very well in real estate, apparently. He's got a lot of friends who help him out.
I
mean,
no, I think
good for him to be able to figure out how to become governor and then become
a
millionaire.
Yeah, but he'll probably be running against Barack Obama, who's so close to Goldman Sachs. They're his biggest donor, who's so close to so many CEOs. This little Merck thing is going to be nothing compared to Barack Obama's ties.
I agree with you. I think that's a liability that the president have. I mean, frankly, I think that's a liability that most of our government has at this point. But in the context of the Republican primary, I think that's going to resonate. I think there's a certain
there's a crony capitalist backlash. That's what they think TARP was. Now, the problem with Rick Perry is that a lot of Republicans, they don't know him very well. They know him by his book, and they know him from two debates. So they're still forming their opinion. So to that degree, I think it does hurt him.
But let me ask another question on the immigration issue. Now, I thought Perry's a guy who stands tall in the saddle. He does not run away from his position. I think that's what's going to happen. Maybe we'll get to the Ponzi scheme.
Social Security, not so much.
Well, he continues to use Ponzi scheme. He says,
you have to remember something, that Paul Krugman was first to call it a Ponzi scheme in 96. Yes. Milton Friedman's called it a Ponzi scheme. Noted, respected economists on both sides of the aisle called it a Ponzi scheme.
Well, Obama's whole stimulus package is a Ponzi scheme. But let's talk about something else, the immigration. Perry wants the children of immigrants, even if they're illegal immigrants, to still be productive, to get the in-state tuition for state colleges so they can be productive. I think the Republicans are usually lousy on immigration. I think this is a great position for a Republican candidate to have, and I think Perry is dead on. Now, will it hurt him, however, in a conservative, right-leaning primary? That's what I want to
know. Listen, when that issue came up, that crowd did not much like his answer at all.
Right.
And that's another issue. You have the crony capitalist charge. I mean, you know, Romney's looking for places
but
to get
But how can the GOP win if they lose, they get blown away on the Hispanic vote, for example?
No, listen, the long-term future of the Republican Party, if they're only getting 30% of the Hispanic vote, they're not going to win many elections. That's a big difference between 2008 and 2000, is that whites voted in about the same numbers, but there's so many more Hispanic voters that really partially do McCain. So they need to get
Texas
those Hispanic
Republicans,
voters.
Like Florida Republicans, know a lot more about how to deal with immigrants and Hispanics than some far western Republicans, for example, maybe from the state of Alaska. I won't mention any names. Mark Simoe, what about jobs growth? Did Perry stand up to Romney on jobs growth in Texas?
Romney might have gotten the better of him, but again, Perry's brand new in the race. Romney's been at this for 8 years. For it to be that close a game says a lot for Perry's ability.
Are you suggesting that after we get the polling results in, that Mitt Romney is going to be the new front runner?
He may have picked up a few points there. You know, Perry never had a tough debate in Texas. He always had an easy time there. So this is the first real tough debate he's been in. A couple more of these and he'll be great.
Listen, I love the betting, the online betting markets. Before the first debate, they had Perry up by 7. Now after the second debate, Perry's down by 7. I think there's been a little bit of a shift.
All right, Sam, come back to you. I know you're hostile to these candidates, but there's
it's not so much the candidates, it's what they stand for.
Yeah, I know. It's the candidates and what they stand for. It's okay.
Totality.
And, as I said, Ron Paul had this guy dying in a church, not on the street. I just want to preserve Ron Paul's honor. But in all seriousness, look at
it's the fact that he let him die.
All right.
Nevertheless.
Unfortunately, things happen in life. I can't defend it. I probably wouldn't have said it if I was up there. But I want to ask you about this. The governor, Governor Tim Pawlenty of Minnesota, has endorsed Romney. And there's now a whole crew of Republican establishment people. This is very interesting to me, who believe that Perry is not electable and Romney is electable. As a Democrat, I want you to take a whack at that. Could they be making a big mistake? Do you remember years ago, the mainstream media and the establishment said Ronald Reagan was not electable? What's your quick take on that?
I think the Social Security thing is going to be a big problem for Rick Perry. I mean, because, like you say, he's trying to fudge. He's trying to walk away from it. But the bottom line is, in that stage, know that that Social Security and Medicare are beloved programs, even by the Tea Party. Oh. And so you cannot
even
you
if
cannot
they are going
a,
bankrupt.
Well, I mean, that's I don't agree with that
even
assessment.
Even if at least
but,
one is a
but they're beloved.
Game.
They're beloved.
All right, we'll leave it there. Our panel: Sam Cedar, Jimmy Pethikoukas, and Mark Simoe. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.